Hey everybody, it's good to be with you in this way, starting something new today. Know the Bible, plain and simple. It's just an opportunity for you to get back into the stories of Scripture, to share some conversation with each other, and to pray. Plain and simple, nothing confusing, nothing complicated. Just get back into the Bible stories again. So today we start with the first Bible story, and each segment that we do, for every story of the Bible, the format is the same. I encourage you to read it first, then view the video, then share with each other what stands out, and then pray. Again, shouldn't take that long anytime, not some huge Bible study in the sense, just going over the stories again. So our first story that we're looking at is the first one in Scripture, obviously, and that's from Genesis chapter 1, the story of creation. So I encourage you, if you haven't done so already, you can stop the video, read the story, Genesis chapter 1, the very first part of the Bible, that first chapter. Read that, and then when you're done, come back and view the rest of this video. Now, assuming that you have read it, the rest of the video is this, talking about it. What is Genesis chapter 1 about? It's about the beginning. It's the beginning in regards to the creation of the universe. It doesn't cover stuff that happened before the creation of the universe, but it starts with the creation of the universe, God creating the universe, which in Scripture is called the heavens and the earth. And so God created the universe, the heavens and the earth. In Scripture, what do you need to know about this story? You need to know that it's broken down into 6 days, and each day a different part of the universe is made. There's debate on whether those 6 days are six 24-hour periods, or each day is symbolic of a huge amount of time. That debate we don't need to get into right here. But then during those 6 days, what happened? You know, what was created each time? So it's good to know. These are important things. The first day is light. Let there be light, God said, and there was light. Kind of flipping the switch on to be able to see what God is doing, to see Him and the creation that He's making. Second day had to do with creating the sky and separating the waters. So those are the big things on the second day. Third day is the dry land appeared and vegetation began to grow. Fourth day, we get the sun, the moon, and the stars. Interesting that sun and the moon stars aren't there the first day when light is. They don't come until the fourth day. Fifth day, we get the fish and the birds, and then the sixth day, we get the rest of the animals, and land animals, and finally humans. And humans are kind of that last thing in creation. Humans are special. God says we're going to make them in our image. In our image, we're going to make them male and female. They're made in the image of God. And then on the seventh day, God rested. Okay? And that's the creation story in a nutshell. Some interesting things. There's kind of like the need to know stuff. That's what you need to know. Then there's interesting things. Interesting things are that, one, I think it's interesting how the first 3 days of creation are kind of like places that God makes, and the next 3 days of creation are things that go into those places. And so you look at the chart, and you got the sun, the moon, and the stars that go into the light, the fish and the birds that go into the water and the sky. And then you've got, on the last day, you've got the land animals and the humans that go onto the land and partaking of the vegetation. Other interesting things is that after each thing was made throughout this week of creation, God said it was good. God saw that it was good. And indeed it was. And it's really important to know, because we have to understand that the universe as a whole and everything in it, including our own earth, our own world, including ourselves, our flesh and our bones, are, even though we mess things up at times, even though we can make life difficult at times, at the heart, in the very depth, we are good. It is all good. As a matter of fact, after God made people, and people are the ones who've caused the most pain, nonetheless, it was after God made people, He didn't say, oops, I made a mistake. He said, and God saw that it was very good. And that's very important for us to keep in mind, to remember that all this stuff is good. It's God's plan. This is what he wants. He wants these things. He's not trying to get rid of them. He's not trying to end the created world and just have some kind of spiritual existence. No, the physical is good. Creation is good. It's indeed, it is very good. Also, as part of the story, and one of the blessings that he gives to the animals and to people, as part of this creation story, is to be fruitful and multiply, which tells us that though, you know, this first story is the story of creation, it's really just the beginning of creation. It's as though he wired us in our DNA and our very being to continue that creative act. And so it's kind of like he started creation and he set it in motion, but now through that command of be fruitful and multiply, he says, now you're going to continue to do what I began. And that's a theme that comes out later in Scripture as well, this participatory nature. He starts something and we participate in it. And so he continues to create today. What else? So that's need-to-know stuff, interesting stuff. And let me end then with connecting things to Jesus. Everything in Scripture gets connected to Jesus and finds its meaning in Jesus. So even in this creation story, we could jump to John, the Gospel of John, chapter 1. It says, in the beginning, was the Word. The Word is another name for Jesus. Before he put on the flesh, he could be called just the Word of God. And all things were made in him and through him. In Colossians, it talks about it this way. For by him, Jesus, all things were created. So everything on that list that is good, all these things are God. Jesus created these things. Jesus is the one through whom all these things were created. In heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, all created by a thing. All things were created through him, and they were created for him. Now, all of creation being created for Jesus doesn't mean that, like, you know, he's the toy maker, now he's got all these toys to play with. On the contrary, what it means is this, is that all things find their meaning in him. And everything on the list finds its meaning in Jesus, finds its identity in Jesus, finds its fulfillment in Jesus. The writer of Colossians says, he is before all things, and in him all things hold together. So all the things of creation in the heavens and the earth, the whole universe, is held together, find its unity in Jesus. He brings its unity. In fact, it's in Jesus and it's through Jesus that we are finally able to rediscover and see once again that we and the universe is good, is good. So that's the first story of the Bible in a nutshell, plain and simple. What I encourage you to do now is to take some time to share with each other, someone in your household or a friend or someone, and just simply, maybe you both read it, you both watched the video either together or on your own, and just share this. What stands out to you? From this story, what stands out to you? Make it plain and simple. You don't need to be, again, doing a whole study on it or you don't need to do a whole sermon. I'll do sermons on Sundays. That's okay. Just what stands out to you? It may be one thing. It may be many things. Doesn't matter. And then after that, take some time to pray. And not too much time. Just, you know, pray for each other. I pray for you. You pray for me. Anything else on our minds? Just someone says, you know, Lord, we pray for such and such. Amen. Then you've done it. And then finally close with the Lord's Prayer together. Then that's it. You're done. I encourage you to do this week by week. Next week, we'll do our segment number 2, second story of the Bible, which is Adam and Eve. I look forward to seeing you then. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.